NASA basic photographs is quite new compared 3 years ago. We were preparing material presentations of photographs and field photographs. And it was at that time that Marisa and I were doing the first talks on construction. And 1 year ago, a survey with all the main results of basic photographs appeared as one chapter of my research. So this presentation is to show the discoveries that took place in the last 2 months, mainly about the classes of basic photographs. So we will need to have an introduction and make the photographs, so, as most of you know, graph is folded when every cycle of at least 4 or more has a quote, which is an edge showing 2 non-consecutive vertices of the cycle. And photographs can also be characterized by having a big tree. A big tree is a tree whose vertices are complete in the graph, and such that for every vertex P of the graph G, family C to P of clicks contain that vertex P uses as a tree of P. So to have an example, let's consider the graph G left. It is a border graph and it has a clicks. We see here the clip graph G, and in color we have a click tree of G. For example, we can see how the clicks that contain the vertex P uses a tree. And how the clicks that contain I also uses a tree. We can also check the same condition for every reference. Well, unit photographs are the two graphs of photographs, and they also have a tree that characterizes them. We call it the compatible tree, which you find a suspended tree of the graph, such that every click of the graph uses as a tree of T, and we can also define a compatible tree using glossed neighborhoods instead of clicks. So let's go back to the same graph. So this was a photograph, then this is a dual photograph, and if we wanted to have a compatible tree for this graph, we can use the property that every big tree of a photograph is a compatible tree of its click graph. To have an idea of why that's true, let's consider the same click tree as before. To prove that it is a compatible tree for PFG, we could check the condition that every closed neighborhood of a vertex of PFG induces a subtree of the click graph. For example, let's consider the click C8. What we see as a vertex here, it's close neighborhood can be seen as the clicks that contain shape, the clicks that contain H, and the clicks that contain I. All those families of clicks are subtrees because we know that this is a click tree, and when we unite them, we have a larger subtree. So taking this for CA and for all other clicks would assure that this is a compatible tree. But however, conversely, it is not true that every compatible tree of the click graph, the color graph, is a click tree of the color graph. For example, this is a compatible tree for PFG where the closed neighborhood of CA now is the graph, which is a tree. But for example, we consider the clicks that contain vertex P, they are C1, C2, and C6. And when we look here, they are not a subtree of the tree that we are considering. So we have a compatible tree of P of G that is not a clicked tree of G. So this motivates the definition of basic polynomial graph. We say that a graph is basic polynomial if the compatible trees of P of G are exactly the clicked trees of G. To determine whether a graph is a basic polynomial graph or not, what we can do is to consider for every minimal vertex separator family visit S of bricks contained in that separator, and the family visit S of bricks that intersect every other brick that has an empty intersection with S. So, for example, if we consider this graph and the minimum reference separator 2,5, the bricks that contain 2,5 are C2 and C3, so that's visit S. Every click of this graph intersects the separator 2,5, and the clicks that intersects all other clicks are C2, C3, and C4, so those three clicks make the family C2S. Well, what we say, we can say that a graph G is basic color if and only for every link of separator of S, the family C2S is equal to the family C2S. Yes. So this graph that we are considering here is not a basic color graph because these separators, C2S and C2S are different. But for example, this graph is not quite different from the other, but it turns out that it is a basic color graph. One way to verify it is to make a table with all the minimum vertex separators of the graph, and for each of those separators we can identify the families C2S and C2S and check that they all are equal. And in fact, something else that we can see from these examples is that the graph, basic color graph, is not hereditary because this was not a basic color graph. This is a basic color graph. And the previous graph is an induced graph of this one because the only difference are these vertex and these two edges. In fact, we have this result that tells us that every polar graph is the induced graph of a basic polar graph. The construction that allows to prove that property is for a polar graph G, let's take every sufficient vertex is non-sufficient vertex of this graph. And for each of those vertices, we will have a vertex B star and the edge B B star. After that construction, we obtain a new graph G prime, which is basic polar. So G prime is basic polar and has G as an induced polar. So this motivates to consider the class of hereditary basic polar graphs. Which is obviously defined on the graph that are basic polar, and such that its induced graphs are also basic polar. This is truly a hereditary class by definition, so it is a natural question if it is easy to characterize through a family of forbidden induced graphs. So to try to find that characterization, let's suppose that we have a graph that is not basic polar. So by the characterization I showed before, we know that there is a separator S such that C sub S is different from C sub S. Every minimum separator can be expressed at the intersection of C3, C1, and C2 such that S separates the vertices in C1 minus C2 from the vertices in C2 in C1. That is called separating graph. Now let's take a click C3, which is in B sub S minus C sub S. By definition, C sub S is contained in B sub S, so if they have this difference, then it means that there is a click here but not here. Well, if this click is in B sub S, that means that it intersects all the clicks that have an empty intersection with S, and that can only happen if the intersection between C3 and S is non-empty. So let's take a vertex in that intersection. As the click is supposed not to be C sub S, it doesn't contain S, so let's take now a vertex B2, which is in S but not in C3. Now, let's take a vertex in C1 but not in C2. and the vertex in the V4 of the C1. Finally, let's take a vertex V5, which is adjacent to V1, but it's not adjacent to V2. We know that such a vertex exists, because if all the vertices of C3 were adjacent to V2, then V2 should also be the click of C3 because of the maximality in the definition of this. Well, perhaps these are not all the edges that we have here, because we could have this edge and this edge. In case that those edges are not in the graph, then we can conclude that this graph, which is called the dot, is an induced graph. We can just one of the edges I mentioned, then we can say that this graph, which is called the Shen, is an induced graph, and we cannot have all edges at the same time, because in that case we will have a cycle without poles. And conversely, we can see that the dot and the Shen are not basic quadrant graph, because the quick graph is equal to the triangle. This is trivially a compatible tree for these two graphs, but it is not a quick tree, because the vertices that contain these two are C1 and C2, which do not use a sub-tree here. So we can conclude from this that the class of the entry basic quadrant graph is equal to the class of function free quadrant graphs. But this graph has a lot of characterizations, and here I would like to show a list with some necessary and sufficient conditions for a graph to be elementary basic code. Well, one is that every edge of the quick graph of G is exactly T of G, and that no minimal vertex separator of G contains another minimal vertex separator. Another is characterization is in terms of triples of clicks. When they are pairwise intersecting, then we have to have that the intersection of two of them gives all of the same set. The other condition is that we have a click intersecting a minimal vertex separator S. Then that means that S, all the S is contained, see? And lastly, that the minimal vertex separator of G are pairwise disjoint. Now I would like to talk a bit about the structure of the case we see on the graph. One result that we have is that the vertices of a minimal vertex separator of a theoretically basic quadrant graph are twins. That means that they have the same close neighborhood. And to prove that property, we have to take into account that the close neighborhood of a vertex is determined by the clicks that contain that vertex. But if we have a click containing a vertex of S, then we must contain all the other vertices of S because of one of the characterizations I mentioned before in the previous slide. So if we consider the maximum sets of pairwise twin vertices in D, we must have that those sets either are minimal vertex separators or they consist of sufficient vertices. If we contract those maximum sets, which are disjoint, to obtain a graph G prime, then the result is that we have a block graph. So actually, we have that the intermediate products are obtained from block graphs by replacing the vertices by complete sets, and whenever we have an edge in the block graph, that edge is transformed in multiple edges that contain that join the vertices from this complete to this complete. Well, now I would also like to show you that the class of elementary basic quadrant graph is not completely new in the sense that it appeared in many different contexts, obviously when basic quadrant graphs were not introduced. And well, when I return to food plus equivalent to create the color, you can see here to prove that that plus is equivalent to the plus of formal dark gen 3 graphs. The first plus that I'm trying to mention is the plus of 4-6 mid powers that is defined as those graphs of which there exists 15 whose leaves are the vertices of T, and with the condition that for vertices adjacent to the graph T, then the distances between V and W in the tree is less than or equal to 4, and for vertices that are not adjacent in the graph, we have that the distance between those two vertices is 6 or dash. Here we have an example of the bull, and this is a tree whose leaves are the vertices of the bull, and that shows that it is 4-6 leaf power. The next class involves the concept of sufficient power. I would say that a graph T is a case of sufficient power to create of a graph H if the vertices of G equal the set of sufficient vertices of another graph H, and such that for two different vertices, x and y, they are adjacent in G if and only if the distance in H between x and y is at most k. We have that the related vertices for the graphs are the two sufficient powers of log graphs. And finally, there is a relationship between related vertices for the graphs and convexity. In this context, we say that set S is convex if for two vertices of S, every shortest path connecting those vertices of S has vertices that are all contained in S. In that, there we define eccentricity in S of vertex 2, U as the maximum possible distance between U and another vertex of S. We say that U is a contour vertex of S. The eccentricity of U is larger than or equal than the eccentricity of every other neighbor of V of U. In those definitions, we can claim that T is the characteristic for the graph if and only the set of contour vertices of S equals the set of sufficient vertices of the graph induced by S. Well, that's all I have to say about the basic polar graphs. And now I will speak about other subclasses of basic polar graphs. As I have said in the beginning, basic polar graphs appear when conveying three trees of polar graphs with compatible trees of unipolar graphs. So the idea is that we could make that analysis more complete if we take into account that three trees have that polar graphs sometimes have special types of big trees. For example, we find a unique tree as a tree when the set of clips containing a vertex V always induce a path. A DB big tree is such that the edges of T can be diagetic, so that the family of clips containing B induces a diagetic path. And a big tree is an arbitrary big tree where it is a little big tree, and besides, it can be rooted at the vertex. Well, we say that the graph is UB, DB, or RDB, it has one of those features. For example, this is the graph of the first slice. This is also the same big tree, and we can see that it is a UB big tree because color we can see all the paths that the set of links containing each vertex induce. But it is not a DB big tree because if we orient the links containing B and the links containing B so that they induce dielectric paths, then it is impossible to orient the vertices the clips that contain H so that they form a dielectric path because the conflict in directions that required, such that much like viewing photographs appear or photographs by considered deep trees, we could try to see if we have dual classes for UV, VB, and RGB graphs. For three graphs, that approach does not work because the three graphs, UV graphs, are also viewing photographs. But for deep graphs and RGB graphs, that works. And so we define the graph as the graph of UV, viewing graph, the deep graph of UV graph. And it is nice to have similar characterizations to the compatible tree or UDB graph. The similar characteristics is called the UDB compatible tree, and the particularity of this tree is that the edges are dielectric, so that each clip of the graph uses a dielectric path. And seeing that we define UDB graph, we think it's UDB graph and RDB graph, and we have characterizing tree, which is called the RGB compatible tree, and it is a UDB compatible tree that is rooted at the vertex. So now I would like to try to compare the DB with trees with DB compatible trees of KFG and the RGB with trees or G with the RGB compatible trees of KFG. Similarly to the beginning of this presentation, we can see that DB or RGB big trees are DB or RGB compatible trees in the big graph. It is something simple to prove because DB and RGB graphs are equally. That means that if we compare a clip of KFG, it will be of the form B, that is, the clips containing some vertex B of the graph G. We are supposing that G is a DB or RGB clip tree. This set will use a directed path, and if all the clips of KFG use directed paths, then it means that that tree that we are considering is also a DB or RGB compatible tree. However, we don't have a similar result for UV graph because we have seen in the example that this clip tree was a UV clip tree, but however, C3, C7, C4, C5 is a clip KFG, which is not inducing a path in KFG. Once again, we have that the converse is not true. We may have DB or RGB compatible trees of KFG that are not DB or RGB hip trees of G. In this example, this is a DB compatible tree of KFG, and this is an RGB compatible tree of KFG. Neither is a clip tree because the clips containing these yellow vertex are C3 and C4, and we see that they do not induce a sub-tree in none of these cases. However, the converse is true when G is a basic photograph. What that means? It means that if G is basic color and G is a DB or RGB compatible tree of KFG, then G is necessarily a DB or RGB clip tree of G. To prove that, we have to prove that for every vertex B of G, the clips containing B are a subtree of G, or they induce a subtree of G. Well, C sub B are pairwise adjacent vertices in K of G because all of them have non-empty intersection just because they contain the vertex B. So if they are pairwise adjacent, we can take a clip D of K of G such that this contention holds. So we can say that system G, it uses a subtree of G, because we are assuming that G is a basic order graph. So if G is a compatible tree, because it is basic order, then it should also be a Greek tree. So if it is a Greek tree, we know that this is compatible, because it's basic order, it's also a Greek tree, so T, the subgraphic used by C2B is a subtree, and on the other hand, because it is compatible, this Greek must use a diagonal path. In that case, we have a subtree, in a directive path, so this is also a directive path. So if we check that for every C2B, this is a directive path, we can conclude that T is also a DB or an RDB in 3 of T. We can conclude from this that in basic photograph, there is not just a correspondence between big trees of the graph and compatible trees of the graph. But there is a deeper correspondence between more specific types of trees. So we decided to define basic DB graphs as those DB graphs that are basic core, and such that the DB trees are exactly the DB compatible trees of KOT. And similarly, we will define basic RDB graphs as the RDB graphs that are basic core, whose RDB trees are exactly RDB compatible trees of KOT, because of all what I say, we look at the basic DB graphs will be the intersection of basic color graphs and DB graphs, and basic RDB graphs will be the basic color graphs intersected with RDB graphs. That's it. Thank you.